So I'm really gonna need your help on this one.
I don't know why you say that, Max. I've been here the whole time.
Has anyone seen Dr. Cat?
Hi everybody, I'm Max Barner from HIMSS, and this is Uncomfortable Questions. With me here again today is Dr. Pat Carroll. How are you, Dr. Pat?
Doing great, Max.
Dr. Pat Carroll is a board-certified family physician with over 30 years of experience leading medical teams, treating people, and helping people feel their best. In this episode, we're going to be talking about one of our most common questions. Does finasteride cause sexual side effects? But first, I think it's worth going back and having a rundown on what finasteride is, what it does, and how people use it. Dr. Pat, take it away.
Finasteride is a FDA-approved medication that you can either take by mouth, such as a pill, or you can use it topically. The pill form comes in a milligram dosage all the way up to a 5 milligram dosage. The side effects are quite minimal at that dosage, and the medication is very effective. How does finasteride work? It actually reduces the level of the hormone called DHT. And DHT is a hormone that can cause hair loss. So it's FDA approved, the pill, very effective, and it reduces the level of DHT, which leads to hair loss.
Good stuff. FDA approved. People love this stuff. And it's probably gone through some rigorous testing, which means we know a lot about the side effects. But I think, Dr. Pat, what most people at home want to know is what other side effects they can expect.
So at the 1 milligram dose, Max, side effects are minimal. Less than 2% of folks will have these side effects. We classify it into two groups. One is sexual dysfunction. That's things like erectile dysfunction, decreased libido, ejaculation disorder. And the other group are mood symptoms, things like depression. Again, less than 2% of folks will have any of these side effects. Once you stop the oral medication, in the great majority of times, those side effects are reversible.
All right. So a little concerning, but like you said, even at higher doses, only a very tiny population of people who take finasteride really experience these side effects.
Correct.
That doesn't sound too bad. So, for guys who are still on the pill, what can they do to help mitigate the effects?
If you're on the pill and you experience any of these side effects, of course, the first thing you should do is contact your prescriber, your provider, review with them exactly what you're experiencing, and then work with your provider to make a decision on what the options are. One is to just stop the medication and try a topical formulation. So topical finasteride is really around equally efficacious or effective as the oral pill. And what we've seen is the side effect profile is significantly less than the pill. So there are options.
All right, so it's not too bad. So just to sum it up for everybody at home, one, make sure you're taking the medication as prescribed. Don't overdo it, don't underdo it. Let's keep it at what the pros say. Two, if you do start experiencing side effects from finasteride, make sure you tell your healthcare provider as soon as possible. And three, make sure you're exploring your options. If oral finasteride doesn't work for you, maybe they'll switch you to topical and vice versa.
Correct.
That doesn't sound that bad. You know, Dr. Pat, I gotta say, I am really happy you actually showed up for work today, man. Thank you. I'd have been lost without you, Dr. Pat. That is Uncomfortable Questions. I'm Max Barna. This is Dr. Pat Carroll. If you like what you saw here, please do us both a favor and like and subscribe.